all been lied to for so, so very long. The violence, the corruption, the non-feeling, lack of emotion, pushed away, made us back into animals we're not supposed to be. And the Almighty, when the time came that we were given the ability of knowledge, we were no longer innocents of this land, of this world, of this realm. We became something much more. That's why God did not want us to eat of that. Because once we did, our innocence was no longer. And the innocence is such a precious thing. And sad to let go. Watch your children. Watch your grandchildren. We are of God. That is the message that was been skewed and broken and removed and corrupted throughout our history. Jesus was trying to tell you of all. Yes, He is the Son of God. Yes, you are the son and daughters of the Almighty Creator. Knowledge can go either way. That was given our choice when we were given that gift to become. Something was allowed for thousands of years to exist and use corruption and take a tool that was supposed to be as a simple tool to make our lives balanced and corrupted it with greed and evil and power. And it's gone so long. These people, these generations of people who've taken this knowledge and just grafted upon it, instead of making the world better for us and protecting us more, they made it so that they get more, and they get more, and they get more. When we are all supposed to become more. Christ's message was the sacrifice that He gave to see, to be, for everybody to see, to learn. He had knowledges that may have kept him from death and to live on with scars upon him horrendously. And perhaps that's the truth that also was held back, that he did exist afterwards, that made him so much more. He needed to show that this evil, this pain, that we're not supposed to live in that existence, that corruption. We don't have to hate each other. We can look at each other as brothers and sisters and love one another and not look at each other and say, what can you do for me and what can I take from you? All of that has to go. It can't exist. If we're to exist as a species, to exist forward, numbers and all aspects of logic tells you that we are headed towards our own mass destruction. We have the ability and technology now. We have allowed people to live in the corruptions of that level. People have already openly spoke of using these terrors of weapons that could destroy the world. Presidents of the United States secretly conspired to use these weapons in Vietnam. These truths that have been they put away and they hide because of the deception is so evil. If we had any idea how fast the underhandedness is. And few out there have touch upon it. They have a ability to compartmentalize and logic all of this massive knowledge and see the illogic, the questions that nobody wants to answer. You speak to a lawyer and they will not speak to you. They do not speak to you. They speak through the words to you. In such a form and fashion to protect themselves. It's evil and it's corrupt and it's all based off of. And the commerce tool was used to put them on top of the world. And the evil's going to get much, much more. I'm told the snow is coming. And there is a vast amount that it's going to drop upon the world. And even then they will still stand up and say, global climate is real. We need to control this. and the snow is a one-time effect. They lie, they deceive, they are evil. You have to speak and listen. When my time comes, and I hope that I stand even closely as proudly as Jesus did, knowing the sacrifice had to be made. People have to see the evil, and they have to cry. If they don't, there is no hope for us. If they don't, change your hearts. Find the love. Scream out for the love. Hold on to it and don't become the people that hurt you. Do not use excuses of what others did to you that it's okay to do upon others. Be more. Be more. Show them. The Almighty God's greater. His love exists within all of us, and when you find it, it's so powerful. Nobody could even imagine.